So you might recognise our next guest as one-fifth of the UK's biggest ever girl band in this country, Girls Aloud. It's Nicola Roberts. Hello. Welcome. It's great to have you here for the first time. I'm very excited.
It's nice to be here.
So can you tell us about your brand new single, Beat of My Drum?
Yes, I can. I feel like it's a little bit different from what's out there at the moment, and that was important to me when I was making the record. Really just remember having loads of fun making it, and I wrote it like last August, so I've sort of had it sitting on the laptop for a long time, so now that it's finally out there, it's a bit bizarre, but everybody, the whole team, we're all having a lovely time and just having fun, and it's good.
Cool. And what was it like filming the music video for the track? It's your first ever video on your own. Is it quite nerve-wracking?
It was, and I kept expecting the girls to kind of run in off set and saying that they'd done their part, or, you know, the usual shenanigans that go on a Girls Aloud video set. But no, it was just me. But we had a really good time, and there were so many dancers in the video, and the director was amazing. So we all just had a good day.
Now, I'm obsessed with the dance routine in the music video. And so who came up with those moves?
I actually flew out to LA and worked with a choreographer called Lou Brown and his assistant Binky, who are very fly, and they was teaching me like ragga girl, ginge style.
You are getting down. I'm like, oh my God. I was trying to do those moves and it wasn't happening for me. Can you teach me anything that we can do maybe with my hand? You do a bit
we
like.
We can do the chorus.
Yeah, L.
O.
O.
V.
V.
And then you can alternate, so you can either go V.
Yeah.
E.
E.
Or
yeah.
You can just do E.
Ah.
Whichever is your preference.
Nice,
so
okay.
You have.
Next time the video comes on, I'm going to do that move and hope for the best. You usually perform as part of a group.
Yes.
With four girls around you. So is it quite nerve-wracking, you on your own doing it? Are you getting used to it now?
I had my first gig last weekend, yeah, and it was in Newcastle.
Yeah.
And it was in front of 10,000 people. So first performance after not being on stage for 2 years, they threw me in at the deep end. But it was good fun. I was really nervous, but as I'm going along, I'm starting to relax and enjoy it more and just getting used to being on my own.
Okay, and Cinderella Eyes is the title of your debut album. Now, where does that name come from?
It comes from a track that I wrote really early on when I first started making the record, and it's a track off the record, Cinderella's Eyes. And it's really about, basically I'm saying like Cinderella woke up and she's kind of asking, what will she find? Will she find a prince or is she gonna find a hoodie? And it's really like, it's my take on how a happy ending should develop. And it's basically saying that I think that a lot of people in the world expect things to really happen to them, and things don't always just fall into your lap, and you have to get up and work hard and be determined and follow your dream for yourself, because nobody else is gonna, you know, nothing is handed to you on a plate, and that's really what the song is all about.
How would you describe the overall style of the album? Is it a mixture of slow and up-tempo?
It's collectively, it's an electronic-based record. So, and I feel like if you like electronic music, then you'll like, there's something on there for everybody, like whether it's a really stripped back song, Sticks and Stones, which is just me, really slow with a Wurlitzer, so just keys, and then you have to the other extremity, which is the Diplo track, Beat of My Drum, which is just crazy, so there's a little bit of something for everybody on there.
And have the other girls in Girls Aloud had a sneaky listen to the album yet?
They like it. It's just nice. It's really good.
And is there any rivalry between you, like when it comes to like solo stuff or no? It's
no. I mean, like we all have different styles and different tastes, and that comes through in our music. I think that my record is very different to like Cheryl's pop R&B record, and Nadine's record really represents hairstyle that she likes. So we're all too different for there to be any rivalry, and we're all like sisters, so that would be not very nice.
No. If you could collaborate with anyone, who would you choose? If
there's
you could
so with many people I'd love to work with.
Off the top of your head?
Eminem is like my hero. Like, I just love him to death.
Can you imagine like a rap record, him and you on the track? Wouldn't
killer.
That be good? Yeah.
Yeah.
I told the world one day I would pay it back. Say it on tape and lay it, record it, so that one day I can play it back. I don't even know if I believe it when I'm saying that. I'm starting to creep in every day. Well, now, a lot of people are loving your style right now. So would you ever go down the route of maybe creating your own range or doing something with fashion?
Well, I really enjoyed collaborating with a shoe designer, Atlanta Weller, and we created the modern-day glass slipper for Cinderella's Eyes, the record. And that is the shoe that fronts a lot of the campaign at the moment. And so that was so much fun, and I really enjoyed that.
And you've recently joined Twitter. How are you finding it?
I love it. I'm addicted to Twitter.
So you just, how many times do you tweet a day, do you reckon now?
I try and like, what's the word? I try and like...
Retweet and whatnot.
Restrain myself.
Okay,
and
so
like,
not
put
too,
Twitter down.
Not
Nobody
too many
wants
times.
To know that you've just had a cup of coffee.
It's true. We do get those odd tweets and you're like...
No, that's not good.
No, definitely not. Well, thank you very much for popping
thank
by today,
you.
Nicola. We wish you the best of luck with your single
thank
and your
you.
New album.
Thank you very much.
And you're welcome back anytime. Thank you.